Okay, let's start off by saying, if you are new to this channel in any way and you're looking to watch said video with me, we do not do that here. I do a timer. We do a 3-second countdown and then we watch the video together. You can go to a source and watch it along with me. If you don't want to do said thing, I suggest going to a different channel. That's what we do here. I know it won't get a lot of views. I know that for everything. But a year and a half ago, we tried this for a week, adding the video and sound. And then just sound, and I got my channel taken down and barely got it back up. So I'm not taking the risk. If you guys do want to watch along with me, that's why I do the 3-second countdown. That's also why we have the timer up there. So I'll be trying to explain that with different videos we do, or I might cut this out and put this at the beginning of each video, at least for a while. But otherwise, if you guys are new, that's what we do here. And we'll probably jump right into the video. 5 episodes of season 2 of Overlord. I have watched and picked up most of the details of episode 8. Well, I keep rewatching it. air conditioning in the background, like always. Let's jump into this, though. Episode 9 of Overlord Season 2. In 3, 2, 1. Like, if you guys didn't see, go check out my channel update video. Okay, so two of them are entering the back door, he's entering the front door. He's gonna just bust it down. Yeah, I kinda figured. Fucking Zebus. Zebus is fucking strong, but I kind of could figure that. He is the head of all maids. I think if anything, Ainz will side with Zebus on this one. Because even if Zebus doesn't know, Zebus is actually helping the cause to be his best thing for Ainz to do is to alliance with one of the sides.
Alright, unlock that. Oh. Oh, is he pervert? Oh, fuck. He doesn't care who you are.
Damn. That's a very neat set of bells. That's weird. That's very weird. Booby trapped? They're finding a way through. It could be a trap. Those boxes are huge. It's not empty. Uh-oh. Hoo-hoo! Illusions. Come on, think.
Poison? No, he's wearing armor under that. Maybe chainmail? You have to think. Yeah. Oh, the footsteps, right? Only one. Was that illusion too? No, illusion, you idiot. He's a master at illusions. Because he faced death in the before. Yeah. You're not. Cloak of invisibility. He's incredible. Wow. Oh, that can't be good. Oh my god, that means one of the fingers is down. That down to seven fingers. This is gonna cause the other guy to come out. At least that takes rid of all the rest of the slave trade. Yeah, the Pillars of Organization is not gonna love that one. Dogs barking, I think my mother's home. Hehehe
I feel worried for the princess's sake. She's the one with the sword, right? That makes so much more sense about the ending then, because the ending kept on confusing me, because it kept on showing the princess, but then the alter image of the princess, like, where she, like, mind broken, same thing with the lady with the hood here, she's shown differently. So my guess is we're eventually gonna see it, but I didn't think we'd get it this soon. Oh, we're getting an extra scene here. It's, I keep forgetting this is not one that shows previews, so we actually, I usually skip through to see. But let's just keep watching. Oh. Yeah, Severus will have to chat with Aynes. The six arms. There's five of them, though. I don't think they will. I'm gonna give that 8 out of 10. Like last session, we're not gonna just whack around. We'll talk about all four, or all five, at the end. But let's jump into episode 10. In 3, 2, 1. Like I said, I want to talk, review all five at the end. We're just going to give it a score, 1 out of 10.
Yeah, it does look like Severus will eventually go up against Six Arms Chief.
Ooh. I don't think she wanted that. Sorry.
You did not suspect that one, did you, Severus? Sebas. Good to ooh. Oh, it reminds him. It's cool seeing old members of the guild. Ooh. The maid. job is. Okay. Damn. He's gonna go check out that. The six arms is gonna attack that mansion and gonna take her, and then it's gonna cause a fucking war. Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, come on. Why is he occupied? Is the Adventure Guild got him in that on it? I wonder if that name throws something off about her. The name means. It's all unknown. It was just a name, but it could be. My guess is it's his former name within the game world before he got transported here. Otherwise, let's give it that. I don't see anything at the end. Let's give 8.5 out of 10.
Let's jump into episode 11 in
3, 2, 1. Well, I'm hoping you guys like the new schedule and process. He went. Ooh. I like Deliere. I think they're gonna use Aynes in disguise. That's why he's a part of the Venture Guild. I'm guessing they're gonna use this to exploit this situation to even further his reputation. Would be my guess when he's in the suit of armor as Mogmog. Mogmog? I also kind of figured they weren't going to kill her. But I've been wrong before. Multiple times. Oh, too many times to count, actually. Technically, now we've seen everybody in this intro. Oh. From last episode, and my last episode, we saw everybody. I'm actually liking them build up these people. I'm really hoping this is not the I'm really my curiosity is that, or my sense of thought is Aynes is gonna align with this world. Not bad. Damn, there's a lot. Oh, so he was part of the six. I'm forgetting that he sent over a guard. So that's why the six arms. I'm an idiot.
Oh.
One of these is gonna get wiped out and it's gonna send them over the edge.
There you go, all four.
These are, I'm guessing, other members of Eight Fingers. That's not the most important person in there. This is gonna be bad. A Nintomancer. Damn, she's fast with a hammer. Okay, that's awesome. Ooh. What's your real face? Is that just a shell? A face painted onto it? Is it going to be the mage? It has your friend in it, though. Oh, I got her out. It's not a face, it's a mask. It's a bug. Come on. Ooh. Jesus Christ. She's a maid, right? It's a trap. She might die here, or they all might die here. Starting to like this squad, but it looks like they're gonna be dying by the end of the season would be my guess. I kind of figured that they're going to use this. But my guess is they didn't expect those three higher-ups to end up actually taking down the maid. Would be my guess. Or maybe it was a test on them. That's a 9 out of 10. I kind of assumed most of what is happening, but we're jumping into episode 12 now. In 3, 2, 1. The goal is not to kill the adventurers. He almost fucked up there. I think Delier came up with the scheme. Him and Nines, because they're both master strategists.
my guess is we're going to get more backstory on her here.
You have to go help your friends. Healing spell or something.
Unless they're completely dead, like Deliere said. They could be. By the way he was talking, but... The way she was talking, it didn't seem that way, but... Were the Eight Fingers in season one, the old man, was he old part of the Eight Fingers, if I remember correctly? The old man that had this, the thousands of skeletons? She's not well. She has a spell on her, something. He's gonna have some type of martial arts skill, right? That'd be my guess. I'm hoping. Okay, that looks a little stronger. Wow, he has fists as hard as iron. Yes! I always do Fists of Iron because of Gajeel, but also... Damn. Oh. Well, that's a way to take down an enemy.
Ooh.
Oh. Ooh.
Oh, that's neat. I'm guessing they all increase different aspects of his strength. Come on, catch it. I thought we were gonna get more of a fight there, but I shouldn't expect too much. Jesus. I wonder what got her to her heartless self. Ugh. Oh.
fucking... God damn it.
She almost slipped up, but he also almost slipped up. She's right, but... I keep playing with this. I have a bunch of necklaces that I need to find chains for. This is the necklace that Crow wears. It's not much better to get his inner dialogue. You don't get much. There's the Hellfire. Took out 8 fingers. And maybe the the top prince, the oldest prince. I wonder if anybody would hurt Client if the princess would. Her blood would boil. The night captain knows him by a different name. Wonder if they're a well, killed her. This last episode is gonna be fucking packed with shit. They've been slowly building up to this, and this episode is gonna be packed. How much more do we have? We have 2 minutes. I wonder if the next episode is gonna be longer than 23. You gave her the ring. Ooh. She's very twisted, but people eventually become that way through certain situations. Okay, that out of 10 too. Most likely I'm gonna give this last episode 10 out of 10 because what they're packing this episode full of. Let's jump into episode 13, last episode of season 2, in 3, 2, 1. It's still 23 minutes long. It's not a long episode. But they could do no intro and no outro. They've done it before. At least I think they have with Overlord. Other series do it all the time. Like right now we're getting intro credits, not during intro, so... Also, we got the Goblin Slayer movie to pick up this week. Or next week. That's why you stay with the group. Did he just throw his weapon? Please don't do an intro, just go straight into the action. The ultimate trump card. I wonder who gave him the ring then. Ooh. Shed a tear. Huh. He went through the nail. What up? Recognize the kid or the ring or what? Ooh. Ooh, no, you won't. They are strong, I'm more than certain. Oh. Oh. They might not see how special it is, but for him, it means that he's at least somewheres. There's the captain. Oh, it's the king. Look at that beast. Damn. Well, there goes the mask. Not all of it. A portion.
Huh. Damn. I like him. He's very, very intelligent. Yeah.
She doesn't. Damn.
I'm guessing the mask is actually more than just a mask. It's more of a item to hold back. The mask is probably something keeping back her. Her, not her memory. It. Certain magic powers within games or franchise were actually built within the phrase of when something lives long enough, it takes away memories or takes away desires of certain kinds. So I'm guessing it's a magical mask. The trinket or the gem in the middle. At least that would be my decision or thought. Damn. Damn. So they have the sword. The magic weapon, Icebane. Can you finally see? Oh. She's very cheerful. I give her that. We got the intro song to end the episode.
Damn. She almost got caught there by him. She's hitting towards it, which makes sense. Do they have this the flag of the eight fingers? Be incredible. Okay, we still got about 50 seconds. I'm very curious. The name he has spread across the fucking land. It has been bringing more and more people to him, and it's fucking incredible. You guys will probably get season 3. At least the first 4 because then I have to start rendering stuff because I plan on doing Saints Row 4, some more playthroughs. A playthrough part with my friend. I also want to record some other gameplay parts. Later today. Like I said, you guys might get one or two videos. Oh, let me pause the timer. Clear. It's 10 out of 10, though. Like I said, I kind of figured. No intro, no outro. They play the intro music with the outro, like some of the scenes there. But it does seem like. Because all I know is. He's gonna fight a nation in the third season. That's why I keep hearing is that he's gonna fight a nation in the third season. And my guess was it was not this nation that he's been helping. My guess is his best way is to alliance with the nation. But not all nations will alliance with him or be allies. I'm guessing one of them is gonna step up. I'm guessing the one that we saw in season one, the one that used the magic crystal. What, sixth or seventh tier? Seb is taking out all six arms. Well, five arms. Five of the six arms. Because the kid took out the other arm. For Seb is to do that, they realize how strong he is. I wonder if they find out about the true being of what Aynes is, or Mong Mong is, and still count him as a hero. My guess is yes. The only reason I'm saying that because the 13 top heroes that we are finding out in episode 8 that they talked real quick about is the 13 top heroes are not even human. Some are demon or other races, so I wouldn't put it against them in putting him on the 13 if he ever got found out. Even if he's undead, I think he would still end up on that list just because of the deeds he's done. What was the last 2 minutes? The princess almost let it go that she has a twisted side. The way they kept on building up her and her kissing Cerberus, it looked like there was going to be something. Okay, there's something else in here. Taking over half the country. I'm very curious how season 3 starts. So I might record the next 4 episodes. It's very possible we might finish the entirety of season 3 and then you guys will get probably 2 or 3 parts each week of it. And then I'm going to record more Saints Row 3 because I did some farming offline to my needs. Because I want to do mostly the campaign in the videos. The other thing is, the mask is probably not what I'm thinking is her mask. I wonder if the other two lizard guards or captains were resurrected. Okay. Otherwise, I think that's where we'll end this. If I keep talking, I'm gonna just keep talking, and I'm gonna just keep talking and more, and I'm gonna just wander off. I usually end up wandering off eventually. So we did 5 episodes, each 22 minutes. So, ten extra on to that. So we've been talking about, give or take, 15-20 minutes. No. Yeah, 15 minutes. Season 2 was incredible. I get why my brother disliked the lizard park, but whatever. It's more well built in, but also showing how much more he's attaining of the land here. I'm guessing these 4 kingdoms aren't the only kingdoms on this planet, but the 4 kingdoms we know are probably going to be the first biggest challenges. And my guess is he's going to alliance with this first one. Otherwise, if you guys like the video, give it a like. If you guys haven't subscribed to the channel, I recommend subscribing to the channel to keep up with all of the content. Otherwise, this is Mr. Crazy Deegan signing off. Have a good morning, have a good afternoon, have a good night, wherever you are. Just have a good day. Hopefully, I see you guys in the next video. And like I said, you guys are probably going to get Overlord Season 3 real soon. There's a movie? There's 2 movies? So, apparently between Overlord Season 1 and Season 2, there is Movie 1. Actually, I think these movies are just the whole season, right? Let me quickly check. I'm going to scan through it. Yeah, it looks like it just takes everything in. That's why I remember one of these shows had that. There's an OVA of Overlord Season 1, apparently. Okay. Otherwise, like I said, hopefully you guys did like the video, and we will be jumping in Season 3 probably a couple days from now, because I'm be recording right after this. So hopefully I do see you guys next video. Have a good morning, have a good afternoon, have a good night, wherever you are. Just have a good day. Hopefully I see you guys next video, and peace.